Hey, this is Ralph, and we're still working on that Web Development 1 final exam review here. So I just finished formatting the header part of the web page, and I'm pretty happy with it. Logo's where I want, search box is sized and roughly where I want. Links are over here in the top right corner. HTML5 badge is in the lower right corner. Now I'm going to start working on the left column, and of course this is my unstyled or partially styled page. So this is looking pretty messy with all the content but no styles. The finished product looks kind of like this. So I need to get this table of box office info, I need to get this form styled, and I need to get this advertisement sized. So basically I'm going to focus on my left column right now. So let me jump back over to my editor, and I just finished search box, links, and badge and things like that. So let me myself a little bit more room to work. And now I'm going to start working on my left column, which if I double check with my HTML file is called left call. Alright, so ID left call. So let me start working on that one. And let's see, according to my directions here, don't forget I am referring to a list of directions, and I just took care of pretty much this header section. Now I'm looking down here at my left column, and it tells me my left column has a red background, matches red container, there's the hex code for it, very light gray font, it's exactly 240 pixels wide, bunch of information. So I got all this information here I'm going to keep referring to as I'm working on it. So I'm going to move my directions off to my other screen so I can read them. During the test you had a printout of the directions. Dual monitor is definitely the way to go, though. So, all right, left column has a red background. So, let's take care of some of this. Oops. Background color. I'm going to do 900 for my red. The foreground color, or text color, just says light gray. So, I'm going to do a very light gray. That's almost white there. I'm just going to stick some padding in there. The width of this is supposed to be 240 pixels wide. And since it's a left column and I'm doing a more traditional two-column layout, I'm going to go ahead and float this column to the left. And let's see, and it's supposed to be exactly 240 pixels wide. And in the directions it even says use the box sizing to ensure the width is 240. So I'm going to do, I'm going to start off with the Moz box sizing, and I'm going to do border box, and then I'll just do box sizing border box. Since I'm testing here in Firefox, I'll make sure I use the Moz prefix there, the Mozilla prefix, in order to ensure that it's working there. So that will ensure that my box is exactly 240 pixels wide. Why did I need something like that? Because I have this padding in here. If I didn't do this box sizing rule, then really my box might be like 250 pixels wide. 240 for the width plus 10 pixels of padding, at least on the left and the right. So, oops. Dismiss. All right. So that actually happened, I think, in one of my other videos. So a little reminder there for me. So there's my left column, and I guess that's pretty good. And I don't really need to do any positioning in this one because pretty much the content of that left column is really just top to bottom. So let's start working on a few things. My left column, let me scroll this up, has some headlines in it. Headline twos, actually. I used a few headline twos in there. I don't know what I'm going to do here. I'll just do font size. And I don't even think I told you to do stuff in this direction. So this is really just a personal taste, I suppose. Font size. Yeah, I'll just leave it at that for now. Don't want to worry too much about it. So let's start working on this table. So I do have a table in here. In my left column, there it is, there's my table, and it doesn't have a unique ID. Unfortunately, there's only one table in my left column, so this is safe for me to do. And for my table, I'm going to give it a small font size, and I'll set the width to 210 pixels, because that's a little bit narrower than my 240 pixel column. Now I want to do a little bit of formatting of the cells in here. I'm just going to do a copy, paste, and I want to format the TD tags in here. And let's see, I'm going to do a vertical line top and padding I don't know, I'll try three pixels. Okay, let's do that. Now this is where, of course, in the directions it has, you know, I have all this in here. The numbers are in the first. So basically, the first item in the left column, I'm reading off the directions, is a table with three columns listing the sales for the top. Yeah. The numbers are in the first cell, titles in the second, amounts in the third. So you made a little table. The first cells are bold, the second cells are normal, and the last cells are bold and have right-aligned text. All right. So kind of a lot of stuff to keep track of there, but I think we can do that with some pseudo class selectors. So I've got my cells written out. Let me just copy that. And left column table TD colon first child. Okay, so this is going to be the first cells. Actually, that needs to be the first cells within the row. So let's do it this way. So basically the first cells in each row within my table within my left column. So basically my first column. That is supposed to be bold, so easy enough. Font, weight, bold. All right, and then the middle ones are normal, so I can kind of ignore that. I copy this, paste, then we'll do the last child. And it says they're supposed to be text-align right and bold, so I just need to add text-align right. Okay, kind of curious, save that. Browser. Refresh. Looking pretty good. I'm not worried about those bullets over there. Don't concern yourself with it. Yeah, that's not so bad. What does the finished example look like? Oh, it's got white text. Looks like there's a lot of light colored text in there. What did I have? Oh, I do have light colored text. I'm sorry. Yeah, that's not bothering me at all. That looks fine. Of course, my movie titles are all the same length, but sure. Let's call it good. Let's jump back over to the editor. There we go. And after that, I need to start working on the form that's after that. So there's that show times, you know, the form where a person can choose what movie tickets or what movie times they want to go see. It's ID show times. So let me start banging that one out. Bring my directions over here. Let's see. After the table is a showtimes form containing two selection menus, a text input and submit input. I've already created those. Put several options of each. Done. The select menus and inputs in the showtimes form are size larger than normal. That's it. They're just size larger than normal. And then after the showtimes is the advertisement. The advertisement is a little narrower than the left column. Piece of cake. All right, so showtimes. There's selection menus. There's a couple selection menus in there. I'm going to do, oops, something like that. Width, I'll do 200 pixels. Height, I'll do 30 pixels, be kind of nice and big there. Font size, 14 points. And I'll do a little bit of marring, a little bit of margin. I'll do a little 4 pixels. Okay, and that'll take care of both of my selection menus. And let's see, I've also got showtimes input.text. I'm pretty sure I used the same class equals text technique, right? Yep, class equals text, class equals button. Good to know. And let's see, I'll do width 140 pixels, height 30 pixels, font size 14 point. Looks good. And I'm just going to copy this whole thing. Work on the button. The button doesn't need to be that big. How about just 40 pixels? Height, I'll keep it at 30. Font size, keep it at 14. Looks great. Now, after all of that stuff, I do have an advertisement, and I gave it the ID add1. So let me go ahead and take care of that. The directions just say it's narrower than the columns. So add1 width. Oh, that's right. This is the div. I don't want to set the width here. My add1. I'm going to knock it down a little bit though, so let me do a big margin top on it. I'll do like 50 pixels, and I'm going to do text-align center. Now remember, text-align center here is not centering my div. Remember, this is a div. It's basically going to center the inline elements and text that are in that div. So to really size my image, I need to do add one image. I want to manipulate the image within my add one div. And that is going to be a width. I'll do 200 pixels. That's smaller than 240. And let's see, anything else I need to do with it? After the show times, there is an advertisement image a little narrower than the left column. That's it. All right, so I'll just save that. Let's see how things are looking. Jump back over to Firefox, refresh. Yeah, there we go. Once again, not worried about this text here. I'm just focusing on the elements that I manipulated in my left column. There's my table. There's my little selection menus and stuff like that. There's my advertisement. Yeah, I'm a little bothered how much space there is or how little space there is between that headline. But let's not worry about it. How would I fix something like that? I could add some margin top to this headline, or what I'd probably do is put some margin bottom on this table, and that would push those things down. So does it bother you as much as it bothers me? Yeah, all right, what the hell? It's easy to fix, right? Let's go find that table. Let's see, it should be right around here. Ah, here we go. The table. Margin bottom, I'll do 50 pixels. And refresh. There we go. Well, maybe a little too much, but good enough. So now we got our left column taken care of. And now I might as well start working on this main column. I see that my video time is about 11 minutes or so. So I think I'll go ahead and stop this one and pick up the main column in the next video.